Hello friends, before starting this particular session, I have been forgetting about to tell this for the past 2 or 3 sessions. For every lecture from now onwards, in the description you will find a summary link, which is a WordPress article which I am writing now. Alright, so you will find a PDF file in which the summary of that particular session is written. Alright, so that will be good once you have gone through the lecture, and it would be as a good reference notebook. Alright, reference material. But please remember, don't make it that your sole material for your studies. Alright, the best material is the notes that you are going to make. Alright, but these are like small quick notes which you can say to just refresh what you have learned. Alright, so there will be a WordPress article link in the description for almost all the lectures from now, and you can download the PDF file from there and you can have it with you. Alright, so with the previous sessions, we have seen a couple of numericals on RF control as well as armature voltage control. So today it's an interesting topic. So you are going to see the effect of open circuiting a shunt winding, okay, in of course a DC shunt motor. So you can see that if I draw the armature, it looks something like this. So this is the resistance and this is what the field winding. Okay, so this was your RF adjustable and this is causing the flux. Sorry, this is your terminal voltage VT and RA, EA, etc. Now we are going to talk about extremes here, right? We are going to talk about extremes, okay? So what did we do for speed control? We increased the RF so that the speed was increased, okay? But you must remember that this thing was a controlled increase, okay? The increase in RF in speed control was a controlled increase. But now what we are going to tell is that for the some reason, maybe the winding burnt off or the winding got cut from here, okay, something like that happened and the field is open circuited. So we have to see what is the effect of the field being open circuited. Remember that this is a very dangerous condition and it is not part of speed control. All right, speed control is a controlled process, okay. So let's see what happens. So what happens is that when you suddenly cut down this winding here, the winding is made open, so this connection goes from here and then it becomes an open circuit, okay. So open circuit, it means what would happen? The flux would decrease, not in a controlled manner, the flux would decrease drastically, okay. And the flux decrease drastically, EA is equal to K phi into omega. This is a drastic, so I'll just put D here. So EA would decrease drastically, and then you know that IA is equal to VT minus EA divided by RA. So this is drastically decreased, so IA would drastically increase, okay. IA would increase, it means that the torque induced also would increase to a very high level, because this is equal to K phi into IA, this is increasing to a very high level, and this would be very very high as compared to the load torque, and therefore the motor would accelerate at a very high speed, The motor would accelerate at a very high speed and the speed would start increasing. Now most of the loads which are usually used have an increasing characteristic. So if torque is here and speed is here, most of the loads, they have an increasing characteristic. So as speed increases, the torque load also increases. Now when the torque load increases, naturally torque induced also has to increase. So let's see what happens here. Now, due to this increase in IA, a huge increase in IA, because IA is increasing at such a high level, the armature reaction also would increase to a very high level. That means the flux weakening would increase. The flux weakening would be very large. Okay, the flux weakening in the poles would be very large. So what would happen? So torque increases, speed increases, armature reaction increases, and the flux drops. Okay, the flux drops. And due to this flux drop, again the speed would increase. And again the armature reaction would increase. Flux again drops due to the flux weakening effect. And again speed increases. So this becomes a closed cycle. And this is called a runaway. Okay. So initially the field had opened. And due to that, torque induced had increased to a very high level. Due to which armature reaction increased, which further decreased the flux. Decrease in flux means increase in speed. Increase in speed, again armature reaction comes into play, again it reduces the flux, and this is a runaway process. Now, in this is an extreme case, all right, but this can also happen in severe load fluctuation, severe load changes. This can also happen in severe load changes. So what was the solution that we told? It was having a compensating winding. Okay, so was having a compensating winding is a good solution for severe load changes. Now this is a very expensive solution. Compensating windings are quite expensive. Now what is a simpler solution? A simpler solution is having some turns, okay, in series, okay, some turns in series with the poles to cancel the demagnetization, not a lot, it is not an entire set of winding like the compensating winding, it is not an entire set of windings, all right, it is just some turns which are in series just to cancel the demagnetizing effect, and this is actually called compounding. This process of connecting some windings in series from the armature, all right, to the poles is called the compounding, all right, it's called compound windings. Now such shunt motors where you use a little bit of compounding to save yourself, so such shunt motors are called stabilized shunt motors. They are called stabilized shunt motors, all right. So the open circuiting has an enormous impact on the shunt motor. It will go to a very high speed in where the centrifugal forces will be so large that the motor will get damaged. That condition should never come, okay. But for severe load changes, you can either use a compensating winding or you can use a simple technique called compounding. Compounding is a more detailed topic that I will discuss after finishing with DC series motors. So in the next session, we are going to start with DC series motor. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe my channel, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.